Hi guys, very very good morning. I hope you are doing really well. And this is Vitisha Vitlani and welcome to Aussie's Group. We are again back on this Saturday morning with a live session. This is going to be on the letter writing component, a very easy component, a very basic component. So I think once you go through this live session, I'm very sure you'll be sorted of what you're supposed to do when it comes to your letter writing. And technically, I want to explain you a few things that you should know about it, because there are certain elements that we fail to understand at times. There are certain things that we ignore at times, or rather, you know, you can say procrastinated at times. Like we keep on delaying things, which we shouldn't basically. And one thing I would also want to tell you is letter writing is a very important component. However, it's the easiest. If you ask me, in the entire IELTS, there is nothing which is as easy as letter writing. The reason is because we've already done it. Like we're used to doing it, right? So that is about it. But this is what happens. We always, it's the human psyche, isn't it? That when we know something, we're never going to practice it. And that's where we mess up the most. So most of the students, they have this habit. They're going to do essay. But when it comes to letter, they wouldn't even write a single one. And when they go for the exams, you're like, oh, how to do this? So please, before you go for your exams, make sure you read a lot of samples. Like you've read ample samples. At the same time, you've at least written one or two of each category. Like you guys know that there are three categories when it comes to the letter: formal, informal and semi-formal. So when you're going for exam, remember this very very important tip. Please read a lot of samples and don't just read, write at least one or two. What happens is you get used to writing, and when you actually go for exam, you're not wasting much time on this. As you know, the writing component has 1 hour, and this 1 hour is 20 minutes are allocated to letter writing. So if you get confused with letter writing, there is no point of doing it. In fact, I would definitely say that because it's the easiest, it should be the most sorted one rather than exactly the opposite. So this is what real life example I would want to suggest. Like a few of my students had exams of recently again. And as you know, how much are we into the essay, and we've practiced. When it came to letters, you keep on delaying it. No, we've read samples. No, we write letters. We write it. Okay. Then you go for the exam and suddenly it comes. Your reading is done and suddenly comes the last bit, that is the writing, and you're all exhausted, you have no energy, and then comes your letter right in front of you. So basically, you know how it works. You're all messed, you don't know what to do. So please don't underestimate this. Also, I would want to tell you one thing. If you want to score a 7 in your writing component, your letter has to be flawless. It has to be to the point, it has to be exact, and there is no way we can avoid this, absolutely not. And I'll tell you why. See, you know, technically if I want a 7 in writing, which is my minimum requirement for writing always, because you can get 7.58, whatever you want to, but remember this thing, that when you're appearing for your paper, when you're going for your paper, your essay is out of 6 bands, your letter is out of 3 bands. So unless and until I get 2.5 in my letter writing, I will not be able to score. How much ever I score in my essay, I will not meet my average. So that is very very important. So please don't underestimate the importance of letter writing. And we shall now begin how to write letters. We shall now go for it. Okay, before we go for the letter, I would like to tell you a few things about it. Letter writing is the first component when it comes to the IELTS writing part, general training. There are three types of letters. The first type of letter is a formal letter. The second one is an informal letter. And the third one is a semi-formal. What's the difference between a formal, informal and a semi-formal letter? And why is it important for you to know so? Now see, understand the basic difference between a formal letter. Is formal is something that you write for work, isn't it? But natural. Right. Also, formal letter is something that you write to a higher authority. Like let's say I'm writing to a mayor. I'm writing for anything relating to work purpose. I'm writing to my boss for a leave. I'm writing to my school principal. I'm writing to my college principal. That becomes a formal letter. Okay. Now, what's an informal letter? Informal letter is obviously you write to your friends or relative, right? third is the semi-formal letter. Now, what is a semi-formal letter? A semi-formal letter is a letter that you're actually writing to somebody you know. One category can be that, like you're writing to your landlord for the delay in the payment, or writing to the neighbor for some complaint. That's a semi-formal letter. Or if you're writing to somebody like, let's say I'm writing to my colleague to invite him to my birthday party. So it's a colleague, so it's a, like a formal relationship. At the same time, I have invited him. That becomes a semi-formal letter. Now, why is it important to understand what type of letters are there and why? Now, see, the different type of letters will give you different opening and closing. The first thing you see a letter and what you're supposed to do is understand the purpose of it. You read the letter twice or thrice and understand that why are you writing a letter. Like let's say I'm supposed to write a letter to my landlord because I can't pay the rent. Or let's say I'm supposed to write to my boss because I need a leave. That sounds like really interesting one. It's more often we keep on doing it, right? Or let's say I'm writing to a friend because I want a suggestion or an advice. Okay, so the first thing will always be identification of purpose. It's very important. I'll explain you why in the PPT or in the slideshow ahead. Second thing, it's very important to understand what type of letter it is. Now, why is it important to understand what type of letter it is? It's really important because it decides the opening and closing. The opening and the closing of the letter is decided according to the type of the letter. If you know what type of letter it is, you'll be able to give a good opening and a good closing. And the purpose of the letter, which is very, very, very important. Okay. Moving on, there are, as I mentioned, I'll take you through a slide show kind of a thing. I'll explain you each one. I'll show you a live sample that we've written. I'll show you the band descriptors towards the end, like how I scored on letter writing, and then we can end the session. So basically, this is what I'm going to cover in this session. If you have any queries, please post it in the comment box. Please put any suggestions in the comment box. I'll be more than happy to help you. Okay. Now see, as I told you, what is the formal, informal and the semi-formal letter? The formal letter is the one that you write to your somebody of your higher authority, somebody you've not met. So how does it begin with? It begins with dear sir or madam. Put a comma at the end. How does it end with? It ends with yours faithfully. Please, after yours faithfully, put a comma and write your full name. The openings and the closing has a lot of importance, so please make sure you don't mess up with it. Semi-formal letter, it starts with dear, mister and the last name. Remember this. Then it ends with yours sincerely, comma and your full name again. And the informal letter starts with dear and the first name. And it ends with best regards or warm wishes. Okay, so again, let me tell you, there are three kinds of letters: formal, informal, and semi-formal. Formal letter is the one that you write to a higher authority, something relating to work purpose. You start it with dear sir or madam, comma, and you end with yours faithfully. The semi-formal letter is something that you write to somebody you know or somebody at par. Again, it's not very, you know, informal year, so you start with dear and the last name and you end with yours sincerely. The third is the informal letter. And how do you write an informal letter? You're writing to a friend, so you write with dear and the first name and you end with best regards, warm regards and best wishes. Now, what is the difference between all these three letters? First difference that we've realized is the opening and closing. The second difference is going to be the tone of the letter. The tone of the letter is going to be very different from formal and informal. Formal and semi-formal, somewhere down the line, they're going to be the same, right? So don't you worry about that. Okay, even in what I believe and what I have always suggested to everybody is the tone has to be very, very subtle, very, very mellow. You cannot have a tone which is very aggressive. Like let's say, even if I'm complaining to the restaurant, I can't say that I will take strict, I'll call the police and I'll call the cops and you don't know who I am. And you can't do this. You can't keep on ranting. So please make sure your tone is not very aggressive. You can't use extreme tone. Even when you're going informal letter, you can't do hi, what's up there. Doesn't work. It's a letter after all. So please, please understand the fact that your tone has to be subtle. The way you write has to be very, very mellow. Okay, now we just understand the basic format of it. Okay, the basic format goes something like this. There's an opening statement. Okay, the if you realize, you start with dear sir or madam, or dear in the last name, or dear in the first name. Okay, the first thing that I had told you, that you have to understand that why are you writing this letter. Okay, so why are you writing this letter becomes your purpose. I am writing this letter in concern to, with regards to, in context to. That has to be the first line. Imagine you're writing to the company manager. The company manager wants to know what is this in context to. If you see, if you go to see, we remember we have emails and we used to write letters earlier where there was a specific allocated subject line. But here there's no allocated subject line, right? We don't have it. So rather, what I would want to suggest is, if there is a subject line, we can have this. Because there isn't a subject line, the first line becomes a subject line, and hence it is the purpose of the letter. Now see, any letter is going to have three bullet points. Okay, so each bullet point takes an individual paragraph. Getting it? So each bullet point has an individual paragraph. One bullet point, you have to explain it in 3 to 4 lines. Two bullet point, you have to explain it 3 to 4 lines. And the third thing is this. Then comes the closing remark. I look forward to hear from you. I hope you help me. And then your signing off comes with your full name, comma, and your full name. Now remember this one thing, that you have to write your letter in 150 words, no matter what. Your letter has to be in 150 words. You cannot go minimum. Make sure the letter is not too long, because see, there's no, I'll always tell you, there's no negative marking for an upper bandwidth. But the thing is, what really happens is, we waste a lot of time, and sometimes, you know, it tends to go out of focus. So please make sure that you're not going a little bit over the board with it, right? Okay, let's go ahead. I've mentioned few liners that you can use. You can note it down. So if you're stating purpose, you can say, I'm writing to let you know that, I'm writing to tell you about, I'm sorry about, I would like to apologize about. Okay, one thing I would want to correct here is, you cannot really use contradictions unless and until it's an informal letter. Only in the informal letter you can use these contradictions. Otherwise you can go for I am. You can't use the short forms there. No abbreviations are allowed in the IELTS writing. Make sure that you do not do that. Okay. So these are few lines that you can use. Okay. Let's do a sample letter. Let's solve it again together. And that's how I think you would be more able to do it more, because the theory of it. Before that, I would like to revise what's the format, your opening, purpose, three bullet points, three bullet paragraphs, your closure, and your signing off. This is five paragraphs that we're going to write. Okay, now let's read the sample letter. You've received a letter from your bank asking you to acknowledge the receipt of a new bank card. However, the card was missing from the envelope. Write a letter to the bank's head office. In your letter, the first bullet point says, explain why you're writing. The second bullet point says, explain the concern about the missing card. The third bullet point says, ask them what they intend to do. And what am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to write at least 150 words. I'm not supposed to write any address, and I'm supposed to begin my letters dear dash. Now firstly, who am I writing to? I'm writing to the bank's head office. That means I'm writing to the bank's manager. For what am I writing? I'm writing because my card is missing and I have a query regarding it. So what? Firstly, let's understand what kind of a letter this is. This is basically a formal letter. So how is it going to begin? It's going to begin with dear sir or matter. Okay. So this is what I first did. The second thing, why am I writing this letter? What is my purpose? The purpose of my letter is basically that there's a first bullet point which is given, so I can have a separate paragraph for it. It says that I'm writing this letter because my card is missing from the envelope. Okay, so basically these are the two things. Okay, now once you come up with your letter, start cooking a story as to how the flow will be. First decide that in mind. First mind map it and then you can write it. Always pre-hand before, prior to writing the letter, I want you to decide how are you going to write it, what story can you make, okay? So I have three bullet points. The first bullet point says, why am I writing? The second bullet point is asking the concern about the missing card. And the third bullet point is the plan of action, like what they intend to do. Okay, so let's see how is the sample being drafted. Okay, so I begin my letter with Dear Sir or Madam. My first line states, I'm writing in connection with a missing or stolen debit card from your bank. This is an urgent matter as the bank could prove dangerous in the hands of the wrong person. Now, my first line, if you can go to see, is stating the purpose. What am I writing? I'm writing it for the missing card. So, this is exactly how you're supposed to do. The first line, no matter what, has to state why are you writing the letter. Okay, now, the middle line, my second bullet point said, express concern about the missing card. The middle bullet point said, express concern about my missing card. That is what I have mentioned here. Just yesterday, I received a card from the bank's head office. It stated that my new bank card was enclosed and asked me to acknowledge the receipt. However, when the envelope arrived in my mailbox, it was in a tattered state. So I'm explaining the entire situation. Then, more importantly, the debit card which was supposed to be included was missing. I checked and I rechecked around the mailbox, but I found nothing. I'm concerned that somebody has gone through my mailbox and possibly stolen the card. So my middle body paragraph is actually explaining the entire situation, is revolving around the entire situation. The third body paragraph is the plan of action. What would you want the bank to do? So the third bullet point is explained here. For this reason, I request that you cancel the existing debit card immediately. The debit card in question is related to my account number at your Bay and Blue branch. After it has been cancelled, please arrange to send me a new one as I need to travel overseas next week and will need to carry the same one. So basically, the third point says the plan of action. And then I have put a line, thank you in advance. If you feel that you're short of words, you can simply state that I hope a positive reply. I hope you act on this as soon as possible. Thank you in advance. Then you end it up with yours faithfully and your name. Okay, so now mostly my five paragraphs are done. I have missed out on the purpose paragraph because it's already given in the bullet point. So please make sure that you're not very repetitive in your content. Have a glance at this sample one more time. Take a glance at this very carefully. Okay. Let's go ahead. Please remember the format. Opening, the first line has to be the purpose of the letter no matter what. Once you're done with the purpose of the letter, three bullet points will take three different paragraphs. Then comes the closing, then comes your signing off. Make sure your opening and closing, that is your dear sir or madam or dear last name or yours faithfully or yours sincerely, is to the point. Make sure you're not making any errors with this. Okay, I'll go ahead with the content now. A very important point. If I am writing something, how am I going to be judged? Okay, for that you need to understand the band descriptors. The band descriptors have to be understood in great detail, because unless and until you understand the band descriptors, it's not going to work out with you. Okay, I always keep on saying this to my friends, I always keep on saying that to my students, everybody, whenever you're practicing band descriptors, whenever you're studying your, writing component, never miss out on the band descriptors. I have had special webinars specially explaining what's the difference between 6 and 8 bands. We have 2 to 3 videos which are just explaining all the 4 band descriptors in details. In fact, I have 2 to 3 special videos on grammar, 1 video on lexical resource. So you can also check that out, because until you suffice these criteria, you're not going to get your band. And what I want is a maximum band. See, letter is such a thing that you should not even miss out on one point of scoring. Even a single point should not go, because if the point is going, I am going to lose out on my writing average. Writing, as you know, is a very crucial thing. So I any which ways cannot afford this, you know. Okay, let's, as you all know, writing has 4 different band descriptors: task achievement, coherence, cohesion, lexical resource, and grammatical range and accuracy. Now, how will you achieve your task achievement when it comes to letter writing? When it comes to letter writing, your task achievement is up to 5. The thing is, you are understanding the purpose of the letter. You are understanding why I am writing the letter. The moment you understand why you are writing the letter, the moment you state why you are writing the letter, is the moment you get your task achievement. Second, and a very important point, is that you maintain the minimum word criteria. Okay, again, when you are doing those 3 bullet points, you're not just stating, you're explaining it properly. If you go to see our sample, at good 3 to 4 lines of explaining the entire situation in detail. Even the plan of action was like quite much in detail. So this is exactly what you're supposed to do. This is exactly what you're required to do. Okay, now I'll just read out the bullet points for you. Let's check for the 8 bands. For 8 bands, you see this. Covers all the requirements of the task sufficiently. That means you've understood why you're writing and you're doing what you're asked to. Presents, highlights, and illustrates the bullet points clearly and appropriately. That means I have covered all the 3 bullet points individually. I have explained it. I have not left out on even a single aspect of it. Lot of people have a habit of writing introduction, body 1, and conclusion when it comes to letters. I would definitely suggest not to do that. The reason, because when you're elaborating one bullet point in one paragraph, you're more prone to get better marks because you ensure that each bullet point is explained properly. Okay, now what is coherence and cohesion? Firstly, in any time, coherence means relevancy and synchronization. Writing, speaking, or task 1, task 2, anywhere, this is something that you have to learn. And as I always say, the easy it seems is more difficult rather. So how are you going to maintain this? Firstly, you're going to stick to the topic when you write the purpose. Secondly, each bullet point has to be explained, so you're not going out of focus. Make sure that you never go out of focus when it comes to your writing and speaking. IELTS has this one golden rule, and if you follow it, you're going to win this battle. And that golden rule is, answer what is asked. As simple as it. Whatever you ask, just answer that. Stick to the question and you're sorted. Thirdly, how am I going to ensure cohesion? Cohesion is, you can't use a lot of linking devices here, right? You can't go on with things here. So what I'm going to say is, I'm going to actually put on linkers. I'm going to put not many, but whenever I introduce a new idea, I'm going to add one. Also, at the same time, I'm going to have 3 different paragraphs with 3 separate bullet points, which is something that you really, really have to see. Now, let's see what these bullet points are saying. Sequences the ideas and information logically. Now, when I'm taking the purpose, when I'm taking one bullet point at a time, my sequence is on point. There is no error in sequence. So this will help you do that. Manages all aspects of cohesion well. Your relevancy is good, your synchronization is good, right? Uses paragraphing sufficiently and appropriately. You've made your 5 paragraphs, that means you're done with coherence and cohesion. Okay, lexical resource. Now, what is lexical resource? I've had a whole webinar on it, and please watch it. Now see, one thing when it comes to lexical resource in your letter writing is that you don't have a lot of fancy words. Like for your essay, you can have a lot of different words you can use. in your letter writing, what I want you to do is, I want you to ensure you're not repeating words. At the same point, you're using a language of slightly higher order and you're using words which are relevant. Okay, so even if the words are not very, you know, if you go to see, I'll take you to a sample letter after this. You can see the words that they used are not very, very fancy, but at the same time, I would say that they're very normal, they're very decent words, but they're used at the appropriate places. This is what you have to check for lexical resource. Grammatical range and accuracy. Grammatical range means a different thing. Grammatical accuracy means a different thing. What's a grammatical range? Grammatical range means you're using a wide variety of sentence structures. You're using simple sentence, you're using compound sentence, you're using complex sentences. What's a grammatical accuracy? Grammatical accuracy means you're good with your tenses, you're good with punctuations, you're good with comma. Your subject verb agreement is fine, your noun pronoun agreement is fine, and that is your grammatical accuracy. Okay, let's read for the lexical resource for the 8th band. Okay, now, uses a wide range of vocabulary fluently and flexibly to convey the precise meaning. Skillfully uses uncommon lexical items, but there may be occasional inaccuracies. No, we're not creating any inaccuracies. I'm sorry, IELTS has now become very, very strict. So we don't do that. Okay, uses a wide range of structures and majority of the sentences are error free and they make only occasional errors. I don't want any grammatical slips and no lexical resource. IELTS has become really strict in checking now. So please be careful. Now what's the main difference between 8 bands and 6 bands? Let's see, when can you get a 6 band, when can you get an 8 band. Okay, come to the 6 band window. Purpose is clear, there may be inconsistencies in the tone. Do you see inconsistency in the tone? Remember when I began this thing, I told you that please maintain that your tone is accurate. So if your tone is not proper, if you're not very subtle, if you're not very mellow, you will stick to a 6. Okay, so then comes, presents and adequately highlights the key feature, bullet points, but the details may be irrelevant, appropriate or inaccurate. So basically, the in-depth explanation of all the three bullet points in terms of relevancy is very, very important, because if you're not relevant, if you're not proper, if you don't extend your ideas, you're going to land up with a 6. Okay, let's see what is going to be there. Always when you get a 6 in cohesion or cohesiveness, it means that you mechanically used your cohesive devices. Now what is mechanical use of cohesive device? Basically it means overuse and underuse of it. Like when you have mugged up your cohesive devices, that there are some students, I saw the papers, I don't know how, somebody told them that they're going to get good marks in your they're going to get good marks if you actually write a lot of cohesive devices each at the end of the sentence. So it's not like that. Please understand the fact that you have to use your cohesive devices as and when required. Okay, coming to lexical resource, please, when you use the wrong word at the wrong place, there are people who actually mug up a lot of words which are very difficult, and what happens is they use it at the wrong place and hence the lexical resource gets a problem. Now see, in your letter, no, I'll tell you how grammatical range and accuracy can be a problem. We're used to writing letters in a very mellow tone, we're used to writing letters in a very normal, decent tone, and what really happens is we can't make complex sentences. So please ensure that every paragraph has one or two complex sentences, because unless and until it's not there, it is you have to consciously make it in your letter. In essay, somewhere down the line, it's a little bit more natural, or rather we've practiced it so hard that it comes, but in your letter that's not the case. Okay, see, now if you go to see, my purpose is given in the first paragraph. I've elaborated all the three bullet points. My opening and closing is to the point, so my task achievement is there. My cohesion is there because I have maintained my paragraphing. At the same time, I've used cohesive devices. Now see, I have not used firstly, secondly, moreover or stuff like that. I have used a different cohesive device. See, just yesterday, more importantly, for this reason, after. So I have made a very different use of cohesive devices, and which I want you all to learn. Cohesive devices just does not mean firstly, secondly, thirdly, moreover, furthermore. There is much more to it. Rather, that shows your style of writing. So So please now get over the cliche things. Please make sure that you're not going with the cliche things. You're learning something new. It's a letter that you're writing. At the same time, everything is relevant. Only the three bullet points that were mentioned have been explained. Nothing beyond the three bullet points has been explained. So that is again something that you really have to understand. Okay, now I want to show you lexical resource here. That what is lexical resource here? Okay, we've read this letter. We are reading this letter. Can you see even one word that you don't understand? No, right? The words are simple. But is appropriate word at the appropriate place? See, urgent matter is a collocation. Collocation are nothing but couple words. Enclosed, acknowledged, received. Then if you go to see checked and rechecked. Okay. Then there is travel overseas, which is a collocation. So basically, I have written everything that is on point. Coming to complex sentences, each paragraph has a complex sentence. The first paragraph, the last line is a complex sentence. Second paragraph from just yesterday, from more importantly, Mittu missing is a complex sentence. Third paragraph after to with me is a complex sentence. So every paragraph has included a complex sentence. So when you write a letter, please make sure that you consciously do it. Okay. So coming back, I would want to tell you the do's and don'ts when you go for a letter writing. The first very important point, I've been ranting about it, is please make sure that you use proper opening and closing. The second point is use at least 150 words. Your letter should not go beyond the minimum word limit. The third is identify the main purpose. If you're not identifying the main purpose, how are you going to figure that out? Fourth is include all the three bullet points, because including them is very important. If you miss out on that, you're going to miss out on your task achievement. Okay. Then coming to don'ts. Don't go out of focus. No incorrect spellings. Proper words. Don't make it too long. Spend more than 20 minutes. Use abbreviations or symbols. Make sure that you're using abbreviations. You can use abbreviation in your informal letter. When you're writing, you can write, when you're writing to a friend, you can write I'm, but when you're writing to a colleague, you have to write I am. When you're writing to a friend, you can write I'd, but when you're writing to the colleague, you have to write I had. So please make sure that you're doing the abbreviations well. Okay, there are a few things I would want to tell you how to prepare for your general training letter writing. See, general training letter writing, technically, you should, if you have, before your exam, when I started this, I explained it to you, how do you go for it. So before you go for your exam, you actually go for one letter each category. You're taking a request letter, you're studying how to write a letter for request. Choose another topic, practice a sample. When you practice a sample, make sure you time yourselves. Again, when you practice, make sure you have the manuscripts. I'm very sorry I'm ranting about this, but there is nothing I can do about it. The band descriptor table cannot be ignored under any circumstances. And be it for writing, task 1, task 2, be it for speaking, make sure you're considering it the most. Like, I have actually taken a webinar just to explain you the band descriptors, and please make sure that you go through it. Okay. The second thing is a very important part is you are not underestimating this under any circumstances. I have done this mistake. In fact, my students have done it. Please do not repeat this error. If you don't, you know what happens before you go for the exam? You're writing a lot of essays. When it comes to letter, you will never write a letter. Because we have this overconfident zone that, okay, we're going to do it. But when you actually sit to write a letter, you will realize that, okay, this is much more complex than what you do. So, because imagine you have to add a complex sentence, you have to add a vocab, you have to add different things. And that will not come unless and until you practice. So please write your letters and go. At least if you don't find time, please time yourselves and write your letter. Make sure that you're doing all the three categories of letter equally. Now, it's never the case the formal letter is easier and the informal letter is difficult. In fact, I'll tell you, a formal letter is much easier to write than an informal letter. The reason is, formal letter, you're sticking to a point. Informal letter also, you got to stick to your point, but it's more, you get carried away at times, you know. The people are like, hi, what's up, it's been long. You can't do that. You still have to be mellow and you still are talking to a friend, so your tone has to be that. Learn, you know, when you read samples, learn to identify the different tone given in each paragraph. Each letter will have a different tone in which it's written. So you got to learn to identify what is the difference in tones. You got to learn to identify that how each purpose, like let's say I'm requesting something, my tone is mellow. If I'm complaining something, you can't be harsh. You still have to be mellow. You have to remember this. Like for example, last weekend I was reading the sample letter by a student, and suddenly it was a complaint to a restaurant for bad service. And the last bullet point stated that state what you want the restaurant to do. So again, you know what he wrote? I want you to refund my money. I want you to give me a free service. I want you to, you know, book me a room there. And it's such a reputed group. Else I'll post it on the internet. I'll create a negative publicity. You can't do that. You are writing a formal letter that for your IELTS exam. So please, you know, write it in a very, very mellow way. Okay. Again, one more thing. Remember last webinar, I had taught you present an idea and elaborate an idea. You do the same. You take one idea and you elaborate it. Don't, like for example, if I'm complaining the restaurant, I can't say the ambience was bad, the service was bad, the food was not good, waiters were, you know, it was unclean. I can't keep ranting like that. I have to pick up one or two points. Pick 2 points. Let's say I'm going to say that the service was bad. So I'm going to explain the entire service, what happened. Like, I was not very satisfied with the service. Since it was very slow, the order was placed and it came after 1.5 hours, by which the food was almost cold and unedible. So that is something that you have to learn, that you have to have a mellow tone. Also, you can say the chivalry of the staff was missing. So such words, such higher of the order of language has to be used. And again, same thing when it comes to vocabulary. Don't ponder very hard over it. Letter writing, your vocab will be a little mellow compared to essay. For your essay writing, of course, your vocabulary has to be top-notch, and which you will have to learn. Please go through the webinar on lexical resource in case you want more help. In case you want more help, we have a Telegram group where we have vocab pop-up videos. You can watch them. We have already done 30 videos, so that is approximately 90 words. Please like, share and subscribe. Give me reviews on it. I'll be more than happy to receive it. And you have any queries, we are available on Telegram as IELTS Tutorials, and we are there for your service, we are there for your help. Anything, we have writing correction services, and touch wood, we have always been, our scores have always been on point. So it is again a very, very proud moment for me. And thank you for all those compliments that we received. And thank you for all those lovely reviews that you guys have given me. You guys have, we've come, it's almost like what, 6-8 months we are doing these sessions every Saturday, and some of you have been there. Thank you for all this. It does mean a lot to us. We are extremely happy for your support. IELTS Tutorials will always be there to help you, and we'll always be around for your help. Coming back to letter writing, let's not get carried away. There are a few things I would want to tell you at the end, and then wind it up. Letter writing, one, let's just go through it, just a brief summary of it. One, do not ignore it. Please do not ignore it. Second, practice. Read and write. All the three categories have to be given equal importance. Make sure that you're even practicing the informal letter, because that also becomes difficult to write. Third, before you write a letter, two things you're supposed to do. Identify the purpose of the letter, identify the type of letter. Once you're done identifying the purpose, identifying the type, you create a story in your mind. You create what you're supposed to write. For example, for a restaurant service, so I have to imagine, okay, it was my anniversary and I went and the service was not good, or whatever the storyline you want to weave. In case you want to weave a story, it was my friend's birthday and I was throwing a surprise party to him. That way, the third thing that you're supposed to do is, when you write, consciously, deliberately attempt to use the correct language, to use the correct word at the correct place. Attempt to actually create complex sentences. If you feel that your letter is looking too monotonous, change it. Erase it, change it. Write your letters in pencil. I always suggest, in writing, pen is allowed. I always suggest write a pencil, because we're not in the correct frame of mind when we are appearing for your writing component. We have the tendency to keep on erasing it and making it a mess. Don't do that. Okay? So please, please make sure that you're doing this. And yes, so once you're done writing, check and recheck. Now, how are you supposed to check and recheck? I'll tell you. Write one paragraph, count the number of words and check it. Write second paragraph, count the number of words and check it. What are you supposed to check? You're supposed to check punctuations, you're supposed to check articles, you're supposed to check subject verb agreement, and you're supposed to also check whether you've written the right tenses or not. One thing that we make a lot of errors is capital letters. The thing what happens is we're used to typing. When we actually type, this is what happens, that we're not very used to consciously putting commas, consciously putting A and the, consciously not writing the capital letters. Please, please make sure that you do this, okay? These are the few tips that I've given in letter writing, and minimum word limit and the format. These two things are not to be ignored. Post your comments in the comment section. I will get back to you. I will reply them to you. You can join our Telegram group, IELTS Tutorials. You can join, download Telegram and join it ASAP. It is a lovely group where all your queries will be solved. Be there for you there. And you can avail, you can log on to IELTS Tutorials online. We have a lot of mock tests for you to practice. We have a writing correction service. We also have our applications in case you're just on the go and you're traveling and you want to practice any of the components, we are there. So take all of this. The application is free. Telegram group is free. Please avail the services. We're there for you. And thank you so much, guys, for being around this morning. Wish you a very, very happy weekend. Score amazing marks when it comes to your writing, reading, listening. IELTS, rock it. It's just a language examination. As I always say, don't get scared. There, it's going to be really, really nice. Okay, thank you guys, and have a very, very happy weekend.